My wife told her friends she settled for me. We have a perfect marriage. We've been together for 9 years, married for 4. We rarely fight, we're often intimate, we go out on date nights, we send memes to each other, and that works. Recently, we got the news that her ex-boyfriend had overdosed and passed away. Now, my wife has no connection to him, so we expressed our condolences to his family over text and nothing more. She often goes out with her friends, and I always let her. I have no problem with it because I used to trust her 100%. I had to work late, so I told my wife that if she wanted, she could call her friends over to our place since I wouldn't be around. Well, the rains were heavy, and our office was told to leave early because some light flooding was taking place on the roads. I reached home, and I could tell her friends were there, so I quietly went to our room unnoticed. Everyone was speaking quite loudly, though, so I could hear a lot, and the ex-boyfriend came up in conversation. My wife said that 4 years into our relationship, she got a call from her ex-BF, who lived in a trailer, offering to help her see the world. She said she had a bag packed and was ready to leave but decided not to and settled for the stability I was giving her. I didn't know about any of this, she never told me, and she says that, apparently, she settled for me. One of her friends asked her if she ever regretted her choice, and she said that she used to, but not recently. I guess that's it, right? I'm not unstable enough for her to be attracted to me. She has to settle for someone like me. That one word just keeps revolving in my head. I slipped out of the house and went to a cafe to gather my thoughts, but got a call from her asking me where I was, that I was due home half an hour ago. I went back, and she greeted me with a hug and a kiss as always, but I wasn't really into it, and she asked me why my mood was off. I mumbled something like stress from work and went to bed, skipping dinner and our usual alone time, except I couldn't sleep. I woke up a few hours later into the night and sat on the balcony just thinking about how I'm not good enough for her, about how I'm sure she doesn't love me. I know she at least loves me a little, but even for that, I have no guarantee. It's the next day now. I didn't sleep much last night, and my wife is still asleep. I didn't tell anyone anything about what she said because I just can't. What do I do here, guys? Should I even talk to her? Should we divorce? Is there any hope for us moving forward? Does she even want to move forward? I don't know. I'm sorry for how jumbled this is. My head is not really in the right place now. The general consensus amongst the top comments is that he should talk to his wife and decide whether to stay or go. Update to my wife telling her friends she settled for me. Happy update. I posted the other day about my wife saying something jarring. Some people asked for an update, but here it is. Well, immediately after the revelation, I drove to a nearby town, and it took 2 days just for me and my thoughts. I called in sick from work and told my wife that I was visiting a cousin. I then read all the comments you guys had for me. I really wanted to reply to some, but the thread was locked. I nevertheless read each one, and it was a lot of mixed advice. Everyone was advising me to talk to her, but everyone had different views on what to say to her. Some said to just ask for a divorce, some said to ask her what she meant, and some defended her and told me I misunderstood everything. I decided to go for the middle option. Yesterday, I finally confronted her about it. I walked in, and she came up to me for our hug, but I didn't really give one back. She asked me what was wrong, and I told her we had to talk. I sat her down. She could tell I was sad and worried, so I asked her if she was happy with me. She said that, of course, she was. I asked her if she loved me and if she had done so throughout the entire course of our relationship. She looked confused and said of course she did and asked me where this was coming from. I told her I heard her with her friends a few days ago. I heard how she was willing to leave me after 4 years to be with her ex and how she claimed to have settled for me. She teared up and said she didn't mean it like that, to which I asked how she meant it. She said that by settled for she didn't mean that she thought she could do better and was dating down, but that she made up her mind to stay with me because I was the better person. I told her that 4 years into our relationship, there shouldn't have been a question in the first place and brought up the fact that she said she had a bag packed. She started crying and said that that was an exaggeration on her part, that she only considered it, and that was in a moment of weakness when we were having a fight and were briefly on break. Her ex called her because he heard about our fight through a friend, and they spoke on the phone for about an hour, during which he flirted with her, put me down, and offered to show her the world. She said she had a choice between going with her ex or reconciling with me, and she chose me because she loved me and always will. She said that 4 years ago, she was a weaker person and that I made her stronger and better. I then brought up that she said she regretted it but hadn't done so recently. I asked her what she meant by recently. She said that she regretted her choice for only a month after the offer was made because she had thoughts about what could have been, but stopped when she realized that she had the best moments of her life with me. I asked her if anything had happened between her and anyone else during our relationship, to which she said that she had never cheated on me and never would, and I believed her. We were both crying at this stage, and we just hugged and sat together. She apologized for what she said and what she was like 5 years ago. I apologized for listening in on a private conversation without telling her and for doubting that she loved me. I'm really happy that it was nothing but a misunderstanding, and I'm glad we were able to come out stronger. Some people mentioned that I should get a DNA test for the kids, but we don't have any kids, so that's not a problem. Also, she mentioned possibly having survivor guilt, so we're going to look into that, too. Thank you everyone who commented and DM'd me. Your advice was really appreciated.